Hi, I didn't see you there. Well, if you're here to watch my YouTube video, we're going to look at the difference between see, watch, and look. Stay tuned. Welcome back to my classroom where I help you to build your confidence, boost your fluency, and bridge your world with English language. If this is your first time here, hello, my name is Dr. B, and I'll be your English teacher. In today's lesson, we're looking at the differences between look, watch, and see. Now, these three verbs are often confused by English language learners, but be sure to stay until the very end because I'll make sure you know how to use them perfectly. Let's get started talking about the verb look. Look must be followed with either a preposition or an adverb. For example, you can look out the window, or you can look deeply into someone's eyes. Look means to focus on, to concentrate. We are using our eyes with intention and purpose. And generally, we are looking at something or someone that isn't moving, to focus on one item or one object. Now, we have the verb see. And see must be followed by a noun. We call this a transitive verb. See can be followed by a person, a place, or a thing. And see means to notice. We are using our eyes to accidentally come across something. We are now perceiving something by accident. Here's an example. Oh my God, did you see that insect? Now let's talk about the verb watch. Watch is also a transitive verb. So just like see, it must be followed by a noun, a person, a place, or a thing. To watch means to observe. So we're using our eyes to see something in motion, maybe one thing or many things. Oftentimes we use watch with different types of performances or productions. For example, a sports game, a play, or even a movie. Now, I know you're going to ask me, Dr. B, I know you can also see a movie. And it's true, you can see a movie, a film, or a soccer game. Here's the difference. In the past, the correct answer would have always been watch. We watch a movie, we watch a sports game, we watch a performance. However, over time, language changes, and now it's kind of conversationally accepted that you can also use the verb see. The difference here is that we often use see when the performance or production is outside your home, and we use watch when it's inside your home. So for example, if I said, I watched the X-Men movie last night, my listener would understand that I probably watched it from Netflix or at home. If I said, I saw a football game 2 months ago, that means I went outside to a stadium with my friends to enjoy this game. Now I'm going to give you three situations here, and so you can decide which verbs to use, look, watch, or see. In the first example, it's correct to use the verb look. And in our second example, we should use the verb see. And in our third example, be sure to use the verb watch. Now I want to share with you one of my favorite images to help remember the differences between look, watch, and see. Now as you can see from this image, look means to focus or concentrate, to use our eyes with intention at a single item that's not moving. And so the image here shows our eye with one single arrow coming out of it to focus on one single thing. Then we have the verb see. And as you remember, see means to notice, to come across something by accident. And so as you can see from the image here, we have an eye and we have an arrow going into the eye that we're perceiving something by accident. Finally, we have the verb watch, which once again means to observe, to use our eyes to see different items or objects in action or in movement. And so the image here shows our eye with many different arrows pointing in different directions. I really hope you enjoyed today's lesson. And if you did, please give me a like because it helps me to know that you want more videos and lessons just like this. And I'd love for you to comment in my comment section below. Leave me three sentences, one using the verb look, one using the verb watch, and one using the verb see. And if you'd like, I'll correct some of those sentences. And be sure to subscribe to this channel, because in my next video, I'll be sharing with you some adjectives for personality. I'll see you next time.